This video is going to go into a little more detail about negative exponents. So let's start with a situation where you might actually create a negative exponent. Let's say you've got x to the third divided by x to the fifth. Well, our rule for a fraction like this tells us that since the bases are the same, we want to subtract the exponent in the denominator from the exponent in the numerator. So we're going to have x to the 3 minus 5. And 3 minus 5 is negative 2, so we've got x to the negative 2. And then our rule for negative exponents is going to tell us to take this x to the negative 2, make it the denominator of a fraction with the sign changed, and just put a 1 in where we need a numerator. Another way to see how this comes about would be if we actually write out x to the third over x to the fifth as x times x times x. There's my x to the third. And the denominator, x to the fifth, is 5x's. And then we decide to simplify this fraction by eliminating 3 of the x's in the numerator and 3 of the x's in the denominator. So now what we've got is 1 over x times x, which is x squared, which is the same thing we got when we just did this in a faster way, using the actual numbers rather than multiplying out all the x's. Okay, so you can end up with a problem where you've actually made a negative exponent, and then you have to deal with it. While we're looking at these kind of fractions, something to be very careful of is, let's say you have x squared over x to the negative 5. Be careful when you follow the rule for simplifying fractions. Remember, we're going to take this 2 and subtract the exponent in the denominator. The exponent in the denominator is negative 5, which means we're going to have x squared minus negative 5. Those two negatives are going to give you a plus, so we're going to have x squared, x to the 2 plus 5, and 2 plus 5 is 7. Okay, so watch out for something like this. I'd like to take the rest of the time and talk about what negative exponents are. If you're happy just memorizing the rules, stop the video now. If you want to understand where negative exponents come from, what the logic is behind them, then take a look at this. So let's say we start out, we have x to the fourth. I'm sorry, 2 to the fourth. And 2 to the fourth is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. And that's going to be 16. Well, let's reduce the exponent by 1. That means we're multiplying this 2 by itself one less time. So it's 2 times 2 times 2. We could actually go back to the 2 to the 4th and say if we multiply it by itself one less time, that's like dividing it by 2. We could look at the 16 and say, oh, so we're just going to take the 16 and divide it by 2. And that's going to give us 8, which is what 2 to the 3rd is, or 2 times 2 times 2. If we have 2 squared, we're taking 2 to the 3rd and dividing it by itself one less, multiplying by itself one less time, or dividing it by 2, that'd be the same thing. So we have 2 times 2, or we could say that's the same as 8 divided by 2, and 8 divided by 2 is 4, which is what 2 squared is. So 2 to the first, doing the same thing, is just a 2. Or we could think of it as 4 divided by 2. That's going to give us a 2. 2 to the 0 power. Okay, so I don't know what to do here. We can't write a 2. Let's just switch over to here and say, let's take the number that we had before when the power was 1 higher and divide it by 2. Okay, so 2 divided by 2 is going to give us 1. Remember the rule we had. Any number to the 0 power is a 1. Okay, now, so we've had 2 to the 4th, 2 to the 3rd, 2 squared, 2 to the 1st, 2 to the 0. Following this pattern, it's time for 2 to the negative 1. And following the pattern of taking the previous number and dividing it by 2, I'm going to take this 1 and divide it by 2. Well, 1 divided by 2 is 1 half. And remember, we had a rule that said if we have 2 to a negative power, like 2 to the first, 2 or 2 to the negative first, we're going to put the 2 in the denominator and change the power to a positive, which is what we have here. If I go on to 2 to the negative 2, I'm going to take 2 to the negative 1, or 1 half, and divide that by 2. Okay, so just remember how to deal with fractions. Let's think of this as 2 over 1, and dividing by 2 is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal of 2 over 1, or 1 over 2. That's going to give me 1/4. But if you think about 1/4, 1/4 is 1 over 2 squared. So once again, I took that 2 to the negative 2, I put it in the denominator of the fraction over here, changed the sign, and got 1 over 2 squared. And this would continue. 2 to the negative 3rd would be the same as 1/4 divided by 2, which is the same as 1/4 times 1/2. That's 1 over 8. But 8 is 2 to the 3rd. Okay, so actually, these negative exponents just come about logically by taking a pattern that we can make with exponents and continuing that pattern to their logical conclusion. Okay? Like I said, if this helps, if it helps you to understand why this works, that's fine. If not, just remember the rule and you'll be okay. Apply the rule when you have a problem with a negative exponent. Okay, that's it for now. Take care. See you next time.